am just delighted to have such a broad base of support.
I believe tomorrow night we're going to win.
So who will it be? Three men fighting for the Republican right to challenge Governor Culver in November.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us. By this time tomorrow, we'll likely have a very good idea of who the winners will be.
And on this Iowa primary eve, the candidates are doing all they can to get your vote. News Channel 8's Todd Magel has the story.
Well, time is up for candidates running for governor, for Congress, and for a number of other political offices. And we checked in with a few of them tonight to see how they're spending the last few hours before those polls open.
You're my best campaign manager.
You can excuse Terry Branstad for kissing babies the night before the election. This is his granddaughter. She and other supporters are celebrating his latest endorsement. It's from Branstad's mentor.
Governor Robert D. Ray.
Branstad says Bob Ray taught him everything he knows about politics, so it only makes sense two former Republican Iowa governors would look out for each other.
People in Iowa really pay attention, and I think paying attention will tell them that this is the man we want to elect as our next governor.
The polls seem to agree, but
we'll wait till the votes are counted before we declare any victory, but I am just delighted to have such a broad base of support. The endorsements that we've received from newspapers, the endorsements that we've received across the state, and the people that have stopped me on the street that say, thanks for running.
I think we have an opportunity to shock not only the state of Iowa, but to shock the entire country.
Republican Bob Vanderplaats is closest in the polls to Branstad, but in one last trip to TV stations across the state, the three-time candidate says some of those polls are flawed.
The last poll in 2002, they had me at 17% and I had 32% of the vote. Because you need to poll primary voters. People are gonna vote in the primary. Not just registered Republicans, because not all registered Republicans are going to go to the polls.
And Roxanne Collins' campaign workers are busy working the phones. The polls show her winning the Democratic primary to battle longtime Republican Senator Charles Grassley.
The persuasion speech tonight, as it has been all along, is we need a candidate who can take on the special interests. We need a candidate who can take on Washington, and Washington is represented by Charles Grassley.
And the best thing about all this, you get to decide all tomorrow. Kevin and Stacy, the polls open at 7 a.m. They close at 9 p.m. Plenty of time to get out and vote.
There are 41 contested races across the state tomorrow.
Now, the three biggest, again, the race for the Republican nomination for governor. Terry Branstad, Bob Vanderplaats, and Rod Roberts all want the chance to face Governor Culver in November.
The race for the Democratic nomination for U.S. Senate to challenge Senator Charles Grassley, as you just saw, Roxanne Conlon, also Tom Fegan, Bob Krause. And vying for the Republican nomination in Iowa's 3rd Congressional District to face Leonard Boswell in November are Scott Batcher, Pat Petrosh, David Funk, Jim Gibbons, Mark Reese, Jason Welch, and Brad Zahn.
And Central Iowa's most experienced election team is ready to go. Our live primetime coverage begins tomorrow night at 9 o'clock with the candidates, live with the candidates, the results, and the expert analysis from Dennis Goldford.
And don't forget, online, KCCI.com is ready as well. You'll find fastest results, live streams of the candidate speeches, and minute-by-minute headlines as the Iowans out there pick their candidate.